Today we're going to find out how to determine the model number of the 3.5-inch disk that resides inside your external hard drive without physically opening the case. This can be useful to know if you plan to shuck it due to the fact that specific hard disk model numbers have different characteristics and behaviors. For instance, the Western Digital Easystore's Elements and MyBook series may contain red label or white label disks, and among the white labels, some may exhibit 3.3 volt pin issues while others don't. I won't go through the exact differences in behavior between specific disk models in this video, but I'll leave a link in the description where you can find these details. On the Seagate side, you can find out the internal model numbers of the Backup, Backup Plus, and Expansion series, and compare them to the desktop or Barracuda type disks. So the challenge is to find the model number inside the enclosure without having to open it up. Unfortunately, the built-in Windows tools such as System Information, Disk Management, and the Device Manager don't report the internal disk model. For example, when I plug in a Western Digital Easystore, Windows simply reports it as an Easystore 25FB USB device. To find out what's inside, we'll use a free program called CrystalDiskInfo in Windows 10. There are other utilities that you can use not only for Windows, but for Linux and Mac OS X as well. I'll be focusing on Windows, since that's what I use. What you'll want to do is Google CrystalDiskInfo and click on the first link that's returned. After the crystalmark.info page loads, click on the download link. You can get the zip version, as well as the source code, but for the purposes of this tutorial, I'll just grab the executable version with the installer. This takes you to the download page, where it'll download the file automatically. Clicking on the downloaded file, the installer will start, where I'll accept the license agreement, and then hit Next, Next, and Next to accept the defaults, and finally install. By clicking Finish, the program will launch, where you'll see that I already have a C drive in my computer. When you plug in your external drive, it'll normally become the next lettered drive, which is D in my case. If you plug it in, like I've just done here, while CrystalDiskInfo is already running, it won't automatically show up on the user interface. You'll need to shut down and restart the program, after which you'll see the newly plugged in drive, as you can see here. So, let's do that for the Western Digital Easystore 8TB hard drive. I'll plug the powered drive into a USB port, after which CrystalDiskInfo retrieves a wealth of information, including the product number, capacity, the firmware, the serial number, rotation rate, the smart information, and most importantly, the model number, which is WD80EFAX. With this number, you can look up the compendium linked in the description to get more information on this model. In a previously published video, which I've linked as an info card in the top right corner, I go through the motions of removing the disk from the Easystore enclosure, where we discover that it is indeed a model WD80EFAX, which is a red label disk. I've also linked to my video on the 3.3 volt pin fix if you happen to get a white label disk. Now let's try an 8TB Seagate expansion. CrystalDiskInfo reports the model number as ST8000DM004. Again, I've linked to my video where I take it out of its case to reveal a Barracuda Compute disk with a green label. We can see that the model number, according to the label, is indeed the same. Finally, let's see what's inside a 5TB Seagate Backup Plus hub. The program tells me it's an ST5000DM000. After shucking the drive in this previously published video that I've linked above, we discover a Seagate desktop disk with a white label, and CrystalDiskInfo proves itself to be accurate. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.